Hey guys, this is Abhishek from gadgetreviews.com, and today we are going to give you an overview for the Nokia Lumia 1020, which has been launched here in India. As you can see, we have the 41 megapixel phone with us, as you can see, and again it has the 41 megapixel sensor at the back side on the camera front. And when it comes to the overall design, this one definitely looks like the Nokia Lumia 920 in terms of the overall design, but again it is quite slimmer in terms of the thickness, and definitely the camera part is a little bit bulging out, but again the camera is really good and it won't make any problem, especially as far as portability is concerned. So it will go into your jeans pocket quite easily because it has curved edges over here, which are again smooth and matte finish, and they will not attract the fingerprints over here or over here. This is also matte finish, very good quality of material which they have actually used at the back side, and it does have a proper grip as well. It gives you a nice grip when you hold the device in one hand. As far as the specifications of this device is concerned, this device is around 10.4 millimeter in terms of the overall thickness. When it comes to the weight, it is 158 gram, so it is again fairly okay in terms of the phone of this much of display size as far as weight is concerned. When it comes to the display, you have got an AMOLED capacitive touchscreen display, 16 million colors, and the resolution of the display is 768x1280, and this is how the display look like, as you can see. And again, the text size is that you won't feel any pixelation on this display. The display size is 4.5 inch diagonal, and you get around 332 pixels per inch on this display, which is again fairly good. As far as front glass protection is concerned, you have got Corning Gorilla Glass 3 protection on the front, which will again resist to the scratches and fingerprints. You can also go for a screen guard in case you want to protect the screen. It does support multi-touch. You have Pure Motion HD technology, and this display is also a clear black display. And as far as viewing angles for this display is concerned, it is pretty good. You can view the screen at extreme viewing angles, either from the right or from the left, without any issues, or from the vertical angles as well, there is no problem. There is a very little amount of fading of colors which is happening. Before we go further on, let me just give you an overview about the connectivity and the ports which we have on this device. Here we have the big mesh for the loudspeaker. You have the micro USB port for data syncing and charging the device. You have a lanyard port over here, as you can see. On this side you have nothing, no button. At the top you have the slot for the tray for the SIM card basically, and it should accept a normal size SIM card, I guess. I'm not too sure, and we will confirm this later on. You also get the SIM ejection tool, which will come within the package of this phone. When it comes to this side, the design is almost the same which we have seen on other Windows phone as well. You have the volume rocker over here, a plastic button. You have the power and sleep key for the device. You have the dedicated camera shutter key for this device, which will wake up the device as well if you want to. You have these connections over here, which are actually for the dock as well as for the camera grip. So again, you can have a camera grip with this device, which will allow you to not only charge the device, but you can also use it to mount this device on a tripod to take better photos. When it comes to the back camera is a 41 megapixel sensor camera, and it comes with two flash. One is the LED flash which we see over here, and second is the xenon flash. Especially these flash will definitely help you take much better photos in low light. Storage model which Nokia has actually launched here in India is the 32GB one, and it has 2GB of RAM, 32GB of internal storage, and out of which around 4.93 is actually used by the operating system by default whenever you get the device out of the box, and you get around 29.12GB, which is fairly high amount of storage which you get free on this device. The exec version of Windows Phone 8, which comes preloaded on this device as far as operating system is concerned, is this one, as you can see, and it is, and you will get the Nokia Smart Pro camera application and the Smart Camera application pre-installed on this device, so you can actually take much better photos from the Nokia Pro Cam application which is there on this device, because this application not only gives you normal controls, but it also allows you to control over a lot more other options related to photography. For example, you can slide this thing over here to access all the options. You can control over the settings over here, as you can see. You can control over the, so basically you have controls for all these things include, and you can have a lot more things under your control. As you can see, you can control over the focus as well. You can make it to manual in case you want to, and you can also control over the white balance over here. You can control the flash obviously, And when it comes to photos, the photo quality which you will get from the 41 megapixel sensor is going to be pretty good. And let me just show you the settings that how you can actually take photos and how you can actually take the better good photos on this device. So when it comes to the picture settings, as you can see over here under the Nokia Smart Pro camera application, you have the aspect ratio which is 16:9. You can also change it to 4:3. And when it comes to the capture mode, right now it is set to dual capture. Dual capture means that it will not only capture a 5 megapixel photo and save it, and it will also capture a 34 megapixel photo. And how it does that is, it captures a 34 megapixel photo and then it resamples the over image and then creates a 5 megapixel photo out of it, which will be a much better photos with, on which you can actually zoom in and zoom in into the details which you have on this, on that specific photo. And we will just show you the example of that as well. So you do have the option of capturing only the 5 megapixel photo. So when it comes to the memory size, the 5 megapixel photo will take around 1 to 2 MB approximately on your device, on this device. And if you set it to dual capture mode, then in that case there will be two images that will be saved on the device. However, you will be able to see the 5 megapixel photo, and then again you can open any photo from the photos application by tapping on the Nokia Smart Pro camera application link at the bottom to take a look over the 34 megapixel photo version of that image, so that you can zoom into the details and you can actually crop certain part of the 34 megapixel photo to create another 5 megapixel photo out of it. So when it comes to faces, you do have the option of detecting faces over here. When it comes to the videos, the resolution on which you can actually capture the videos on this device, you can capture both 1080p videos as well as 720p videos on this device at these frames per second. So you can capture both of the high definition videos at 720p as well as at 1080p at 30 frames per second. So as you can see, we have just taken this photo using the 41 megapixel sensor camera which we have on this device, and this is how the photo looks like. And this photo has been created by zooming into the complete 34 megapixel photo which we have captured from this device, and we can again select the kind of aspect ratio we would like to have for this photo. As you can see, you can have it 3:2, 1:1, 16:9 as well. So let's take it to 4:3 and let's capture this part, and let me just save it. And once we save it, let me just show you the final complete image from which we have actually cropped this one. And this thing was actually very far away from the point from where we have actually captured. Open this into the Nokia Pro camera application, and once we have opened this, we can actually zoom back. This is the full image which we captured. This is the complete 34 megapixel image which we captured, out of which we can actually create multiple images of 5 megapixel like this of those objects which are very far. Because this device does give you a lossless 4x of digital zoom, it allows you to create multiple photos from the 34 megapixel photo which you have captured on this device, and then you can save them and you can always revert back to the original photo which you have and create more photos out of it. Now, talking about the device, from the front side we have the 1.2 megapixel camera on this device, which is a fixed focus camera, and it is capable of recording high definition video at 720p at 30 frames per second. When it comes to the back camera is capable of recording video at both 720p as well as at 1080p, 30 frames per second again. When it comes to the zoom, you get 4x of lossless digital zoom. When it comes to the connectivity options, you get Bluetooth 3.0 on this device. You have NFC supported as well. You have support for 3G as well on this device, especially the version which is launched here in India. As for geotagging as well, face detection is also there. You have dual capture. And again, in order to capture photos of different types, you can actually use different kind of lenses. And in order to access that, you just need to tap over here to access all the lenses which are available over here. So you have the Nokia Smart Camera application which we actually saw on the Nokia Lumia 925, and this camera application comes pre-installed on this one as well. You have the Nokia Cinemagraph application which will allow you to actually capture photos with some animated objects in that. You do have a lens for the panorama mode as well, so you can capture panorama photos as well from this device. You have Bing Vision to scan the documents, and you have the default camera application as well in case you want to use this. And again, when it comes to tap to focus, you do have tap to focus without actually taking a photo in the Nokia Pro cam application, as you can see, and let me just focus it over here. So we have just taken a photo, and let me just show you the scene. So let me just first of all focus over here and take a photo. And you can not only capture simple shots, but you can also capture macro shots on this device with some third-party application, which you can again install, which are available in the Windows Store. So this is how the photo looks like again, as you can see, and it has been taken with flash, and the clarity of the photos of the object which you capture in it is pretty good, because the amount of zoom which you can do once the photo has been taken to create more photos from that 34 megapixel photo which you have captured is pretty amazing, because you can actually save this image separately. So we can save this image separately, and later on we can actually go back and create another image from the 34 megapixel photo which we have saved. Make sure that you hold the device at the right distance in order to focus properly, unless it won't focus. So we have taken the same image again, and this one is without flash, and let me just go. So this photo is also pretty good in terms of the overall clarity, as well as in terms of the colors, I would say. So the camera on this device is definitely exceptional, much better than the any other camera which we have seen on other smartphones. So when it comes to some pre-installed application, apart from the regular applications which you see on Windows Phone, you get Book My Show, you get this application, the Camera 360, you also have Hair Drive, Hair Maps, which are again will help you to do a proper navigation with this device. It works on the basis of assisted GPS again. When it comes to other application, you also get Nokia Cinemagraph, you have Nokia ProCam, Nokia SmartCam application also pre-installed. You also get OneNote Panorama application pre-installed. Again, the photo beamer will allow you to share the photos with the non-Windows Phone devices. Again, this service is pretty good and it is supported now on this phone. You also have transfer data, and you have your movies as well on this device, just like you see on the Nokia Lumia 625. So again, this will allow you to watch Bollywood and Hollywood movies. You can download those movies as well onto your device. Apart from this, you, in terms of the overall operating system, you get the Windows Phone 8 operating system with all the options which you might have seen on other Windows phones as well. You have Tap to Send, you have Flight Mode, you have Kids Corner, you have a lot more other settings within this OS, which will again help you to do good day-to-day tasks with ease without any problem. When it comes to the processor configuration, you have 1.5 GHz dual core Cariad processor, a Snapdragon processor on this device. You have Adreno 225 GPU on this device. Lithium polymer and battery of 2000 mAh on this device, which is again non-removable, and the back cover cannot be removed. The battery cannot be cannot come out from the device again. All the important sensors, including the accelerometer sensor, gyro sensor, proximity sensor, compass sensor as well, which will be required for navigation to some extent, and you also have barometer sensor on this device. And one thing I would like to mention here is that you do not have a micro SD memory card slot to expand the storage of this device. The storage version which comes here in India is going to be 32 GB one, whereas the 16 GB will come to India or not, we are not sure as of now. So now here we are looking over the assembly of the Nokia Lumia 1020 41 megapixel camera sensor lens, and again this is not the same size which we see on the device. Definitely it is amplified, and as far as the lens and the parts, they have been amplified to 3x as per the actual size which are there on this device when it comes to the camera. So you have Carl Zeiss optics on this device, you have the mechanical shutter which is there, and this is how the whole assembly is going to look like. It is consisting of 6 lenses, as you can see over here. Again, not the same size, but this is how they are actually assembled within the phone, and this is the complete unit. So you have a metal kind of a mount over here, and then this one, and then you have all these 6 lenses, and then you have this plastic thing over here which holds all these 6 lenses together, and then you have the actual sensor, which is the 41 megapixel sensor, which actually captures all the images over here, as you can see. And again, everything which we see over here is very much smaller in size on this device, but they have been amplified to actually give you an overview that how is the overall arrangement when it comes to the lenses and other parts which are there inside this device as far as camera is concerned. So that's all from us as far as the quick hands-on review and overview of the Nokia Lumia 1020 We really like this device as far as camera is concerned, but again, when it comes to the operating system is again the same which we have seen on other Windows phone. There is nothing different. There are some few applications which will definitely give you much advantage, at least on the camera front. But again, on the whole, it is again the same Windows phone which you might have seen earlier. And we will give you a detailed review of this device very soon. You can like this video if this video helps you by clicking the like button below. You can subscribe to our YouTube video channel for more videos like this by clicking the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.